tell you what, this morning I was feeling tired. Not motivated. Like a lot of weekends, I guess, sometimes. No, I take that back. I think most of the time I'm pretty keen to go. But after getting a little sweat on and getting that lawn mode, it's good work. This random video, you know, while I was watching some stuff on YouTube where they were preaching how consistency is the key. I feel like I've got my consistency down, so for me it's a lot about intensity now. I think for a lot of you who are joining me on this journey from the start, I'd say consistency is the key, Hunted. Like, I've been doing this for 10 years. When I first started, it took a bit of time. It took 3 months for me to realize that I could make every excuse under the sun to not train. And I did. I took a 2-week break. Felt like my body almost reset, but it didn't. I probably got back into it within a couple of weeks. Then I probably trained and did a bulking routine for 6 months. Then did a cut, with my first cut for 3 months. And then I went on holidays, and of course failed to continue to cut whilst on holidays, and that disrupted the routine. And soon enough I realized that it was harder to actually be consistent than it was to lift something heavy or be active. It was very cathartic for me to want to go do exercise, and yeah, enjoy.
As far as summer goes, I'm not even close to wearing you like clothes when nobody's home. Now I don't see a ghost everywhere I go. Oh, oh. And as far as I know, you need me the most. Now I'm not on the inside. You talk, but at the same time, saying nothing. Now all I see is daylight when you're gone. If you don't wanna say goodbye, say goodbye. Say nothing, no running back. Say nothing, if you don't wanna say goodbye.
Today's session is going to be about. We are going to try and make the most of it by making sure I got enough calories and enough fuel. So I'm just having a protein before a protein shake before I actually go to train. Yeah, it's summertime, so I'm all about the Berry Blast protein at the moment. It's a bit expensive. I think they're about $1.75 a scoop. Very expensive, but anyway, it's tastes kind of like a juice instead of a milkshake, which in the summer I think makes a big difference. So it's nice. I kind of get to treat myself to this protein, which means that I've also had my breakfast, so I've got what I think is enough fuel to go hit this sesh. which will actually be a predominantly mobility session. I'll do a bit of stuff on my hips, bit of stuff on my tits, so calf work, ankle work, shin work, whatever you want to call it, and then just because I love it, we'll do some heavy stuff. I mean, that's the stuff that makes you feel good after the workout. I feel like no matter how much mobility stuff I do, I don't feel as good, and I like the little high that I get and just going to my day like, tss, 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 tss. You know, that's what it's about, eh? So yeah, probably a good time to ask, what do you think about anabolic window? Hit me up. Let me know what you think, and I'll hopefully learn something or consolidate what I already know, which, from what I understand, it doesn't make too big of a difference, especially for somebody who trains like I do, three days a week, 4 days a week, not a professional athlete, not training 8 hours a day, 6 hours a day. Shahans seems very intrigued, and there's a little smirk in what I've got to say. You got any views on the anabolic window there, Shahan? That's a nice little song you got going on, Shahan. Alright, so I might check back in once we actually get this session started.